In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear friends, fraternal greetings to you from the Carmelite Fathers, and welcome to Carmel Light, reflection on the day's Gospel. It's the 31st Sunday in Ordinary Time, Year B. The Holy Gospel according to Mark, chapter 12, verses 28 to 34. One of the scribes, when he came forward and heard them disputing, and saw how well he had answered them, asked him, "Which is the first of all the commandments?" Jesus replied, "The first is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: You shall love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these." The scribe said to him, "Well said, teacher, you are right in saying, 'He is one, and there is no other than He,' and 'to love Him with all your heart, with all your understanding, with all your strength, and to love your neighbor as yourself is worth more than all burnt offerings and sacrifices.'" And when Jesus saw that he answered with understanding, he said to him, "You are not far from the kingdom of God." And no one dared to ask him any more questions. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. My dear friends, love is a word that we like to hear often and frequently used in our conversations, especially with our near and dear ones. But at the same time, also one which is highly misused because of personal gains and benefits. In today's Gospel reading, Jesus is asked one of those questions where the questioner is probably expecting a short, simple statement on a large, complex subject. Which is the greatest commandment? This is the question, which is very large, complex. I mean, the subject, and the questioner is expecting a very short and simple answer, maybe one word answer. Even so, it seems that Jesus doesn't need to stop and think before answering him. He refers back to the words of Moses, which the scribe would have known very well, and which we hear in the first reading, Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 2 to 6. "You must love God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength." The difficulty here, my dear friends, is that we can't see and hear God or get to know Him in the way that we see and hear and know each other, isn't it? We can see our friend, we can see our neighbor, but how to see, feel and touch God? Then how to love Him? God is different from us, beyond space and time. He is a creator and not a fellow creature. We often feel the difference and experience a sense of complexity in knowing and loving God, a feeling that is entirely different from knowing and loving another human person. Jesus' answer suggests two things: that God isn't immediately accessible to us, and so we have to take conscious steps to make contact with Him. And secondly, that it also takes time. Coming to know and love God is something that takes place gradually, and it is not an overnight success. It's spread out over the course of our whole life and maybe even beyond. But Jesus doesn't leave things half-baked. He adds a second commandment, just as important as the first, saying, "You must love your neighbor as yourself." If our love for God is real, Christ is saying, it will express itself in love for our fellow human beings. This is important, you see. If our love for God is real, Jesus is saying, it will express itself in love for our fellow human beings. You need not do something extra. It will automatically outflow. Obviously, this love is different from the particular and exclusive love that we reserve for family relationships and the people we are emotionally close to. The love that Christ is proposing here is more a determined effort of will to surrender our own self-interest for the sake of the needs or the welfare of others. It's a determined effort, conscious effort of will to surrender our own self-interest for the sake of the needs and the welfare of others. It is more a matter of a basic stance towards anyone and everyone, our neighbor. Anyone who is in need of help is our neighbor, than a cluster of emotions that come into play in our close relationships. It is a love that's free from any calculation of results or benefits, a love seeking no reward. Christ Himself showed this form of love throughout His ministry. Most of all, when He embraced His cross, praying for the people who had conspired to kill Him. So here is something costly and difficult about Christian love, my dear friends. It's the one that enhances our spiritual stature and brings out our resemblance to God. But at the same time, it goes against the grain of all our self-seeking inclinations, and that's where problems can begin. People in Jesus' time, just as much as in our own, were happier with limited, manageable notions of love. They preferred, as we still prefer, to draw dividing lines, recognizing obligations too, and showing concern for people on one side, but refusing solidarity and even sometimes freely exploiting those on the other side. Christ did not preach a religion of love in a way that only patted people on the back and made them feel good and comfortable about themselves. For him, coming close to God and being drawn into the circle of his love is always going to be something that challenges our lack of love and sometimes our refusal to love our neighbor. So, my dear friends, all that we do in the church, in our families, and at work should not flow out of a sense of compulsion, but out of love for God and neighbor. Obedience is not the first duty of Jesus' disciple. Love is. I repeat, obedience is not the first duty of Jesus' disciple. Love is. Let us pray. My dear friends, it's the birthday of my mom, Severin Pinto from Upinangadi. She's celebrating her 75th birthday. Let's pray for her. It's also the death anniversary of Simon De Silva Maravante and Kosis Costa. May the Lord grant them eternal rest. We also remember our own personal intentions, those who are in difficulty and problem. Those who have requested our prayers, all our benefactors, well-wishers, donors of Bible Diary Project. Lord, help me to love people and use things, not to use people and love things. Amen. Have a wonderful Sunday, my dear friends. May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. This is Father Stephen Pereira, Carmelite priest, and my WhatsApp number is 9481263229. 9481263229. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.